Hi, I'm Finnur, and I work on the Google Chrome extension system. I'd like to tell you how to debug extensions for Google Chrome. Extensions in Google Chrome are just like web pages that you can debug using the built-in tools of Google Chrome. Let me show you how it works. In this folder, I have a simple extension I wrote called Email This Page that allows you to send the current web page address as an email. It also contains a bug, which we'll track down together. I'll start by loading the extension. One option is to use a command line argument, but we'll use the extensions management UI page. The management page shows that no extensions are currently loaded, so I'll expand this section to get to the developer tools and click on Load Unpacked Extension. Then I'll specify the extension and load it. Notice that our extension shows up in the list and a new icon has been added to the toolbar representing the extension. When I click on the button, nothing happens. In the details section for the extension, there's a list of active views. I'll click on the name of the active view, in this case background.html, to inspect the background page of the extension. This brings up Google Chrome's developer tools showing the code for the extension. I'm now going to switch to the scripts view and put a breakpoint where we receive the mouse click event from the user. If I try the extension again, I'll break into the JavaScript debugger. With the panel on the right, I can watch certain expressions, look at the call stack, and check what values the variables contain. Now I'm going to use F10 to step over this line and F11 to step into this function until I get to the console log statement. This statement will output debug information to the console window. I'm now going to clear it. When I execute this line, we'll see the console message. And if you look closely at the current line, you'll see that I misspelled the variable name URL. There's our bug. If I press F10 again, we'll see an error in red and execution stops. Let me go ahead and fix this. I'll use this opportunity to show that you can also use alerts, even from background pages. Now, let's switch back to the management UI page and reload the extension. When I click the button, I get our alert and the extension works as expected. For views that are not active, such as pop-ups and options pages, I can load the page directly and inspect it. For example, my extension contains options.html. If I copy the extension ID, type in chrome-extensions:\paste-the-id/options.html, I can inspect this page. I can even change the in-memory stylesheet on the fly. When you do this, just make sure to also update the stylesheet on disk, because if you reload the page, the stylesheet changes will be discarded. And that's the basics of debugging extensions. To find out more about Google Chrome's developer tools, visit chromium.org/devtools. For more information on extensions, check out our website at code.google.com/chrome/extensions.